U.S. belt plate, small style 1830s.
It's a cat bust.
Alright, hey guys, so I'm out here today, finally metal detecting. I'm using the Technetics T2. I'm running it on the 2 plus mode today. And we're finally out after like a month and it's been raining, but I got a signal here and I'm gonna pinpoint it live. I already got it down here. Right there. Oh, I see something. It's an old piece of brass. Oh, it's a button. Right there. First good signal of the day. See it right there, the tip of my finger. Ah, see that? It's an eagle button. Eagle artillery. First signal of the day. Man, that's awesome. Alright, we'll keep going and we'll get back on the next good find. Alright, got a good signal here. Let's see this out. Button right there, shankless, but it's an artillery button. Nice. Second one on the day. All right, we'll get back. Oh, it's a plate. It's a plate. I stuck a plate. Oh my gosh, guys, I just dug a plate. I never expected this would be a plate. Look, I just dug a U.S. plate. Oh my god. Oh my gosh. Guys, oh my gosh. I cannot believe this. With the T2, I just dug a U.S. belt plate. Oh my gosh. Oh, I can't breathe right now, guys. You don't even know. Alright, we'll get back. I can't talk. It was down there at the bottom of the hole. Alright, we'll get back. I'm freaking out. Okay, guys, I'm gonna Facebook Live this. This is insane. I haven't even looked close at it. I just popped it out and I saw the oval. Oh my gosh. Okay. Oh.
Wait.
U.S. Great Coat.
Nice. Alright, hold on.
Alright guys, so I got the signal, it was blaring. I thought it would be like a memorial. I popped it out and I saw the back and I was like, oh, it's a memorial. But look at that. Sure enough, beautiful U.S. Great Coat. Let it focus, see that? Oh man, that patina is amazing. Right down there is pretty shallow, solid 77, 78. Oh, we're having a killer day. We dug a plate. Buttons, percussion caps. We've had a lot of rain, and this is the same site I've been detecting. Just goes to show how much rain can affect the finds. Man. All right, guys. We'll keep going. This is incredible. We'll get back. All right, guys. Right down here, right after that play, I'm still in shock. I'm still shaking, but I got a little percussion cap. Rain up a 70 signal, a T2. I'm just shocked. I'm blown away. All right, guys, we'll get back. All right, right there. Found a trouser button right on the surface. Oh man, look at that, right on the surface. Sweet. All right, we'll get back. All right, right there. When I'm telling you buttons are on the surface over here, I mean it. Look right there. Button. Didn't even have to dig for it. Look at that. Perfect shank. I can feel it. Yep. Oh, man. I'm having a great day. Haven't been detecting in a while, but this is a great way back. All right, guys. See you on the next. All right, guys. Here are all of my finds today. It was a incredibly short hunt, but, like, it's one of my best. It was a crazy day, to say the least. So, I got some amazing buttons, U.S. great coat, three artillery cuffs, trouser button. I got three percussion caps, a buck and ball. Right next to the plate, I got this, as I was digging a hole, looks like a period piece of glass, and it has a, you can see bubbles in it. If I try to hold it up to a light, you can see the bubble right in the middle. Very old piece of glass. And this was such a shocker. My second ever plate. 1839 small style with both hooks. It has both hooks on there. The soil it was in was nice, but it kind of chunked it up, so it'll clean up nice when I bring it home. But God, that's an amazing find, to say the least. It's one of my best for sure. I can't believe I got another one. This is insane. All right. So those were my finds this hunt. A couple weeks I'm hunting in Charleston, South Carolina, so we'll put out a video then. But it's been an awesome hunt, and we'll see you guys next time. Alright guys, so I got home, and what I'm doing now is in the process of preserving this plate. You can see it has both hooks. This one's in really bad shape, but it's there. It's kind of crumbling, but that's why I'm doing this right now. What that stuff on it is Elmer's glue and water mix that I brushed onto it, and eventually it'll dry and not be white anymore, and it'll basically hold that lead together on the back so it doesn't flake off and isn't as brittle. And that's basically what I did to preserve this. I'm gonna carefully flip it over so you can see the front. Turned out really nice. Keep it this way. And yeah, we'll wait for that to dry and it'll look great. Alright, we'll see you guys next time.